Now that we're on the Roboflow platform, you can see that we have some code generated here. Now, when we hit continue, we must select the data set we want to work with. If you remember from the last video, it was our street level damage detection data. When we click on it, it automatically is zipping the files for us, as we saw in the last exporting video. But because the Google Collab notebook has integrated it, it's pretty seamless and does it on its own. So we are on downloading the code. We want to copy the bottom three lines. You can copy above. I found copying the bottom three lines is the most effective. You can see here, though, that there is an API key that is blurred out. API keys are how you can directly get into your projects, and you do not want to share this with people. For the purposes of this project and this tutorial, you'll eventually probably see mine, but I'm going to disable that API key and make sure that no one can access it. For the purposes of this, you can see here that I'm copying and pasting the code. Of note, if you generate multiple data sets in Roboflow, you want to be careful of project versions. Project versions are going to directly relate to which version of the data set you're using. Here, I'm using version 2, which is the one we created together. If you are creating multiple data sets, it will constantly change project version to the most up-to-date. So be careful if you want to use an old dataset version. Let's use the most recent that we created together. Once we hit done, we can navigate back to the Roboflow integration in our Google Collab notebook.